Alright, hey you guys, so you inspired me on the rattlesnake eggs. I'm going to put this up as a quick and dirty video blog recipe. To all you foodies out there, this is the rattlesnake egg. And we're going to stuff some chicken drumsticks and wrap them up and barbecue them. I'm going to condense what's probably going to take 3.5 hours into 4 minutes. And hope this all works out. We're going to make some salsa verde and some salsa rojo to go with these things. So, I hope you enjoy this, and I hope to continue improving the production value of these as we go forward. Alright, so right here in front of me, I have everything I need to make rattlesnake eggs, starting from the inside out. I have medium cheddar spears, 2 inches long by about 1/4 inch by 1/8 of an inch. They're rectangular so that I can stuff them inside these jalapenos. We got chicken drumsticks, dry rub paprika and garlic powder to go on top of those. 9 drumsticks, 18 slabs of bacon, 18 jalapenos, and 9 cheddar cheese spears. We're going to roast the jalapenos and then stuff them with the cheddar cheese. So I've got all my green jalapenos are the same size, all my red jalapenos are the same size, and the red jalapenos are slightly smaller than the green jalapenos so that we can stuff them inside once they're roasted. We'll cut off the cap, we'll take the seeds out. We'll roast them, we're going to stuff them with cheese, bone, take the bone out of these chicken drumsticks, put the jalapenos in there, wrap them in bacon, spear them with toothpicks so that they don't move, and grill them for 1.5 hours. Okay, so first things first, we're going to cut the caps off all these peppers, leaving enough room that we can get the knife in there and take out the seeds. That's what I'm gonna do right now. All the green and red jalapenos are gonna get capped and seeded, and then we'll fire roast them. You could also roast them on the grill. I find this fire roasting inside requires me to heat up the grill later, and that's what I like. So, again, just taking the cap off, get the knife in there. We can be less vigilant on these ones. All we need to do is get a piece of cheese into the inner one, which is the red jalapeno. So you can cut them a little bit lower. All right, there we go. Boom. This knife is not working. Why is that? There we go. More seeds. So that's what we want to see right there. That's perfect. And we'll take the knife in. Just do a once around, get the seeds out, little knock knock, get the membrane out, you want that white membrane out of there, and a nice empty jalapeno core is what we're looking for, just like that. Okay, let's try one more. Just roll that knife in there. I'm rolling it around my hand. I don't know if you can see that, that angle, roll it around, knock knock, that thing's good to go. Do one more. That knife in there, literally just rolling the knife around, kind of peeling the inside of this thing, get the membrane and all the seeds out, and then same thing with these green guys. I'm just gonna roll the knife around. You can either put it in your hand or you can drop it onto the table. A tapered paring knife like this works the best, obviously, because you can get it deep into the pepper and clean it all out just like that. So rolling that knife around as clean as possible in there. On a paper towel, which is the best way to peel peppers. It kind of saves time and a mess. So you just roll the paper towel over in your hands and take off the skin just like that. Should just be flaking away. You want all the black you can have gone. If there's a little bit of skin at the end of the day, that is all right. So you should have a loose, malleable pepper. Not too much black. Just like that, perfect for stuffing, okay? little bit of black's fine. It'll look pretty at the end of the day. So depending on how slick you want to get with it, I call that good right there. And again, just working really lightly with the touch the skin off your pepper. Finger style, just like that. Okay, so here we have the beginnings of the end of rattlesnake eggs. I've taken my cheddar cheese spears, they're inside of our smaller red jalapenos, and then I'm just gonna simply take that, and you guessed it, stuff it inside of my green jalapeno so that I end up with a tight little unit, and the red jalapeno is totally inside the green one, just like that. I like to match them up by size. I got big going down to small. And so that they all jive, I'm going to do the same thing with these. I might want my big ones up at the front, matched up with my small ones down at the bottom. And that way, the stuffing will be a lot easier. Just like, this. Just ram that in there, massage it down, and repeat, same thing. Make sure the jalapeno is going inside the jalapeno and the cheese stays in the middle, which we want. And so the pointy red end will be up, will be the up end. We're not going to roll these. Red's up. There it is. Okay, finally the stuffing of the rattlesnake eggs again. Just size them up and hopefully your biggest. We're going to go inside your biggest. The membrane's down there, so up. Again, we want the red going up so the cheese doesn't come out, and we're going to keep them that way the whole time they're on the grill. So, I like that. Now comes the bacon. Two strips of bacon per rattlesnake egg to finish. I'm going to take it, close it around itself like that. One piece of bacon, wrap it longitudinally. Or latitudinally first, just like that. I'm gonna take another piece of bacon and wrap it longitudinally, just like that, hopefully joining back in the same spot. So you've got two pieces of bacon perfectly wrapped around the drumstick, and we want to then toothpick that puppy through the center, through the cheese, to itself on two different axes, just like that. And that is a raw rattlesnake egg. Green part of my jalapeno down, red part up, even though we can't see it.
Alrighty, we're just a couple minutes away, and what we got going is the fire's dying down, and I'm rolling and have been rolling these inside and out and just turning them again to keep the red up and the cheese in. Rolling around the grill for the last 20 minutes. And as the fire dies, I'll be taking them off in about 10. How'd it look? Alright. Okay, so it's 3 o'clock. We started at 11:30, 3.5 hours. In the meantime, I made salsa verde and rojo, or what do you call it in Texas, Jessica?
Salsa.
Pico.
Pico de gallo.
Pico de gallo. These were on the grill approximately 2 hours. Rule number one about rattlesnake eggs. Take out your toothpicks. There's two, so we'll cut two of them open. I'm going to get 4 toothpicks. They should just ease right out. You never want to serve those, obviously. And then slice open. They are still piping hot. Our mouths are both burning from them. And plate. Either alone or with your favorite combination of salsas. Whoa. That got a little out there. Pretty?
Pretty.